thank you for inviting me to this session. Now, given that this topic is all about professional multidisciplinary collaborations, let us start by finding out what sort of areas do you represent. Okay, so this also interact with you. How many of you are primarily in medicine? Maybe a show of hands. Primarily in medicine, okay, thank you. That includes our medical students, or can I tell you on medical students? Yeah, great. What about allied health? How many are from allied health? So that could be microbiology or any of those, you know, biomedical sciences? It's happening over there. Okay, alright. How many are from engineering? One more person in engineering, okay. Alright, okay. How many from business? Primarily representing business and industry. Alright, okay. So the reason I ask is, for this equation to work, we need the full collaboration and the cooperation of everyone. So I hope I would have your collaboration and your cooperation over the next 15 minutes as I share this, because I want it to be very much an interactive session rather than me presenting just information. Alright, so here I started. The Center for Biomedical Innovation was, what I want to share basically is the context that led us to develop the Center for Biomedical Innovation, what it's meant to do, and where are we? Years since starting that. Now, the biomedical industry, device industry, is a multi-billion dollar industry, which is expected to grow even bigger, to US dollars 209.5 billion. So Professor Dias and Dr. Dao has very eloquently explained the context in other countries, in the US and also in Australia and New Zealand. So my aim today is to bring it into the context of Sri Lanka and then offer it from the Sri Lankan perspective. What does it actually mean for us? And what are our opportunities, what are our challenges, and what can we actually do by collaborating. So, opportunities wise, we have already heard and we know that we have an available healthcare system, so that's a good place to start with. We also know that we have high-performing students. If you take our public, you know, university system, I represent the University of Moratuwa, we do have very high performing good students, also in medicine. So we have good students. We also have previous success at our university doing this biomedical device type of project. We have some good success, except that they all, you know, fulfill the criteria of whatever that project required, and then they've all been shared. Nothing has actually come into the commercialization space. But we have this way of being able to develop good prototypes. If you look at Sri Lanka, geographically, I think we are in a good location. We are in a location that is more like a doorway or like a gateway to Asia. We do have unique healthcare, or we do have healthcare problems that need to be seen from a developing world. The reason I say that is more and more universities in the West need to find universities in the developing world to collaborate with to overcome problems. We do have a current project that we're doing with Imperial College London, and that was formulated on that very basis. And we also have a strong diaspora community, academics as well as other people in other foreign countries who do want to do something for Sri Lanka. So that's also another advantage. We are in post-conflict era, where the country is geared up for development. So we can write that data and capitalize on that if we are going to bring in device development into that equation. So given that context, those are the opportunities I see. We at the University of Moratuwa, we established this center for biomedical innovation. We have a vision of reaching into the at least in South Asia, we want to actually have maybe a hub that could actually connect people, professionals, as well as the development of biomedical devices. Now, Sri Lanka itself is a very small market, but if we could have presence in the, at least in South Asia, that would give us access to a much bigger population and hence a bigger market. So, we wanted to develop devices that were affordable. Does not mean they are cheap, but at the same time, high quality. Okay, so, as long as we can maintain these two objectives, keeping also in mind regional as well as national healthcare needs. So, dengue, for example, is such a need. Diabetes, for example, is such a need. So, we want to primarily focus on areas that could help nationally as well as regionally. So with this in mind, last year we collaboratively formed this center. As you can identify from the logos, there are medical faculties represented. We have KDU as well as one of our collaborators. We also brought in, apart from engineering and apart from medicine, we also helped in the business community. So TIM, management was brought in to facilitate the business thinking. Because if you take pure engineers, they only think technical. If you take, without offending or causing any conflict, even doctors would only think primarily about solving the medical problem, but not necessarily about selling it. So we wanted to bring the business thinking that would help us to commercialize. Along the way, we also found partners in Auction Bioengineering Institute and not Ataga, but perhaps after today, maybe Imperial College London, and so on and so forth, because we wanted to have that exposure and that collaboration.